not gonna die. I'll let you out in a couple minutes.
Well, just make sure. Last time I couldn't breathe.
Just remember, when I flip over the box, you slip out the back, okay?
Okay, just hurry up.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your very eyes, the great Frankini, who I've just placed in this escape-proof box, will suddenly disappear. Is the great Frankini ready?
The great Frankini is ready.
Okay, then let the magic begin.
Can we have two volunteers from the audience, please?
You too. Would you please turn the box around once? Chester, you're ruining my act. Go sit down.
Come on, guys.
I'm not budging. I don't want him to get out of the box.
Come on, Chester, move.
Chester, go sit down.
Come on, Chester. What he says.
Chester, go sit down.
Let me out, guys. I can't breathe. Let me out. Let me out.
Don't worry, folks. The great Frankini can't get out of anything. Rope, box, chain. Nothing can hold him. He is the greatest escape artist in the world.
I can't breathe.
I can't breathe.
Frank, what's the matter? You okay?
No, it was just a dream.
What?
It was just a dream. Same damn dream.
Work.
Thank you for that gentle reminder.
Frank, wait a minute. You forgot your lunch.
Again. I wouldn't want you to miss my chicken tuna surprise.
Honey, all your lunches are a surprise.
Oh, when are you going to be home?
I don't know. I'll probably be late tonight. Got a new route, and I'm just learning this one. But I can figure a few shortcuts. Maybe with a little luck, I'll be finished sooner than last time.
Well, I hope so. Now, I am working on a new recipe for tonight. Mambo casserole. It'll be ready about 6 o'clock.
If it's anything like your avocado souffle, I may not come home at all.
Frank!
Oh, I'm just kidding, dear. That's a little humor there.
Yeah, very little.
Come on, give me a kiss. I'm late as it is.
I love you.
Love you, too. I'm just here to check your meter.
Check my what?
Huh? Oh, I said I'm just your friendly meter reader. Don't let me disturb you. I'll be out of your way in just a few seconds.
Good time.
Friendly meter reader.
Yeah, that's right.
Then read the meter, friend, and get the hell out of here.
You bet. I'll be out of here before you can say Arnold Schwarzenegger. See, it seems to have dried out. I don't suppose you would have a pen to the bed. Oh, I guess not. Look, why don't I just average out your bill?
Yeah, I can take an average.
That's what I'll do. All right, well, listen, you folks take care. It's really going to be a scorcher today. I'd put some sunscreen all over your body. if I were you, that's what I'd do. All right, have a nice day. Hi, fellas. I'm here to read the meter. Meter reader? Mind if I get by? Gracias.
Yes, sir. Hey, shut up, Diablo. Okay.
Hi, I'm your meter reader. I come to read your meter?
Yeah, all right. Hey, Diablo. Come on.
Could you take your dog somewhere else?
Fine, I'll take him outside.
Thank you.
Don't worry.
We're going to the south.
Yo!
Thank you.
Come on.
Good boy.
Get him, Diablo. Go out for his throat.
Easy. Hey, you want to get your dog out of my truck, huh?
That's good. Get him.
Real funny. Yeah, that's funny. Whoa, nice boy. Easy. Holding the dog.
All right.
Yeah. I'm in the corner of the yard reading the meter. I think I'm safe. I hear behind me, sick him. Tear his throat out. I'm telling you, he turns loose the hound of the basket.
Oh, probably a little chihuahua.
I can't go like this in fast motion. Get up.
You guys knew about this, right? You don't tell me a thing. I walk in here an innocent. I'm mauled here. Come on.
Frank's always attracting the dogs.
Yeah. He looks like a pirate.
Real funny.
Look, there are some advantages to this job, too.
I mean,
there are disadvantages, but there are some advantages
like
once
what?
In a while. Well, there was this little address over at Moore Park. That's really. And there's this, I'm down there, and all of a sudden I hear this cute little voice behind me. I swear, 18, maybe 20 at the most. Uh-huh. And I hear this little voice that goes, I have a leak upstairs. She looked like she could have been Cinderella at one of those Disneyland parties. I'm not kidding. And she's got this quilt on. It's like a, you know, those robes are like quilts. It's got all these little animals, Winnie the Pooh, I don't know. And then she's got her feet, looks like in two dead rabbits. You know, you take a rabbit, you stick your foot into it. She's got these, you know, rabbit feet, and with the little rabbit, I mean, she's so cute. I said, oh, this is...
Wait a minute. How old was this girl?
Well, I think she couldn't have been more than 20, 22.
15 going on.
Exactly. No, seriously. Suddenly I turn around, and I don't believe my eyes. She doesn't look innocent anymore. I mean, the dead rabbits are gone, you know, and all I see is this, like, pink... What are those things called when it's like...
Looks teddy.
Like,
a teddy.
Teddy, yeah.
You, you know. She knows.
Why don't I ever get that route?
You've had a few adventures. Come on.
Oh yeah, I got the weird ones. There's a place on Brighton Street. I mean, this is the weirdest story. I go over to check out the meter. I'm standing there, you know, writing down the... And all of a sudden, I feel this thing around my ankle. I feel it over the other ankle. Like, what the devil is this? I look down. There's this snake.
Oh, come on.
Yeah,
right.
It was a boa constrictor. This big around.
Oh, dragon.
15 feet
fire
long.
Fire-breathing dragon.
15 feet long. No kidding. He started making this...
And what did it say to you, George?
It didn't say that. I got the hell out of there fast. I mean, I'm not into snakes, you know? Can we change routes? You want to switch routes?
No, I don't want to. Change it with him. Not with me.
Never again. I'll never go to that place again. Never.
Oh. I tell you, I can't tell you a story like that, but there was one day I went out to scope a house, you know. I go walking up to the gate. There's a sign on the gate that says, beware of cat. Well, I looked at it and said, oh, yeah, sure, right. You know, somebody's playing a big joke. So I open the gate. I go walking in. I had to go way around in back of the house to find the meter. Finally, I find it. Got my light on. I'm standing there looking at the meter. And over my right shoulder, I hear this.
Sounds like
that's what it was. I tell you, I turn around, and they're about 3 feet behind me. It's about a 250-pound female lion.
No.
No, I swear to
you. No.
And she was looking at me like lunch.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
So all I could do, I read the meter as fast as I could, and I said, feet, do your stuff. Woo! Can you believe it? Beware of cat.
I would have been a blur.
I wouldn't have read the meter.
Beware of cat. Beware of cat in heat.
I think that's it. I think she loved me, really.
Whoa, it's like cologne you wear then. Don't use gym cologne. You gotta switch it. You gotta wear something more.
Climb a tree, slide down your cellar door, ring around Rosie and hide and seek, count 200, now don't you peek.
If I waited long enough, you'd show up.
Listen, mister. I don't know who the hell you are, and I'm pretty damn sure you don't know me either. I mean, it's obvious you got me mixed up with somebody else. or else you're one hell of a practical joker. Look, I tell you what. If you untie me right now, I'll consider it just that, a joke. I won't say a word about this to anybody, and that'll be the end of it. Huh? Oh, what do you say? How about it?
You got some nerve for such a skinny bastard. No brains, no brawn, just one big walking nerve ending. This is one time you're gonna need more than nerve to get you through. I told her if I ever caught her cheating on me again, I'd kill both her and the lousy scum she was with. I would have cut you both together sooner or later, but since you were stupid enough to come back here, I'll use you to get to her.
Look, mister. I don't know what kind of trouble you got with your wife, but you're gonna be in a lot more trouble if you don't turn me loose. Now, I'm telling you, I don't even know you.
You're lying! You think you're going on, huh? You think you were the first one?
Yeah. But damn it, I'll tell you this. You're gonna be the last.
Believe me, mister, you've got the wrong...
You know what it was that made her go for you? Hmm? You think it was that tall, skinny physique of yours? Or maybe your steely blue eyes? Well, that's bullshit. I'll tell you what it was. The same damn thing that always gets me. The uniform.
Uniform? You think your wife made a play for me because she was turned on by this lousy orange outfit?
That's right. She'll go for anything, in any kind of uniform. She usually likes them a little beefier, but this time she was too desperate to be choosy. Did she give you that line about being mistreated all the time, and that her husband was too old and broken down to satisfy her.
I'm telling you, I don't even know what your wife looks like. Listen, mister, if I had run off with your wife, what the hell would I come back here for? Huh? I mean, I'm not that crazy about reading meters. I could always get somebody to trade routes with me, or just average out your last few bills and throw in an estimate. I wouldn't be stupid enough to come back here and take the chance of getting caught down here.
You would if you were greedy enough. That was Doris's big mistake. I knew damn well she'd never settle for living out of meter reader's lousy paycheck. I figured that she'd send you back to look for the money that I had hidden down here. Well, I've been waiting here in the dark for 2 weeks. I would have waited for 2 years till you showed up. I knew you'd come sooner or later. And I wanted to make damn sure that you'd never get out alive.
What can I do to convince you that I don't know anything about your money or your wife? Look, mister, I'm fairly new on this route. I've only been on it once before.
You think I don't know that? I got Doris sneaking a look at the other meter reader through the kitchen window when he opened that cellar door. It had been 3 months since she set foot outside. She tried to run off with a Greyhound bus driver. Did you know that? I caught up with him, beat the hell out of that bum, broke his arm so he couldn't shift gears for a while, and then dragged her back here. Did you tell you that? I told her if she was going to act like an animal, she'd be treated like one. I locked her up in the house and bolted all the windows. I even locked the phone up in the den to make sure she couldn't call for help. When she heard it ringing, couldn't answer it, it drove her nuts. The door to the cellar from inside the house, I kept bolted on the cellar side. And nobody uses the outside doors except you guys. I never go out in the morning, so I was always here when the other punk came by. But you have to be a slow bastard. You didn't show up till almost 2 p.m. today. And you were the one who came last time, in the afternoon. It was only when I got my light bill that I figured out what had happened.
Then all of this is just a guess on your part. Your wife could have run off with anybody.
You just happened to be the first sucker to come along. Oh, she was right about one thing. Did hide the money down here. It's the one place I knew she wouldn't search when I left the house. I used to scare the hell out of her, telling her that the cellar was crawling with rats. Well, I finally got one.
Mister, how can I prove to you that I had nothing to do with your wife taking off?
Yeah, I can't. But you can do something to keep your head attached to your neck. You can call her and tell her that you found a heavy chest bolted to the cellar floor. Tell her you're sure that's where the money is.
How can I call her when I don't know where she is?
Shut up! Now listen to me. I want you to call her and tell her to get a hacksaw to cut the lock off. The stupid bitch ain't gonna know what a hacksaw is. But you tell her to go to that hardware store, get it, and get back here within 3 hours. By that time, I'm gone.
I'm telling you, I don't.
Now listen to me. I'm gonna go upstairs, and I'm gonna get that phone. And I'm gonna bring it down here, and you're gonna call her. And you're gonna tell her whatever the hell you have to say to get her to come over here. Now, if that cord doesn't get down here, I'm going to drag you up to it. Got it? If you don't tell her what I want you to tell her, I'm going to keep you down here till hell freezes over. Huh?
Or maybe, even longer.
I can't do it.
You know, you just might wind up being a picnic for the rats of Doris is so scared of.
How can I get through to you? I don't know where your wife is. I can't call her. I can't do it.
Oh, you'll do it all right. You don't strike me as the Rambo type. You'll do it to save your own hide. Use a cordless. Scissors. Anything to cut this damn twine before the monster wakes up.
looking for something?
Room 330. Hello, Doris.
Frank? Frank, is that you? Where are you? What happened?
God, Doris. He's dead. I killed him. It was an accident. I had to defend myself, but he's dead.
Frank, listen to me. Don't panic. Look, you said it was self-defense. Anyway, no one's gonna connect you with it. Did you find the money?
Is that all you care about? The blasted money? He nearly killed me!
Frank, pull yourself together. Did you find it? Did you find the money?
Yeah.
Answer me, Frank.
I think I know where it is. It's in a box that's bolted to the cellar floor.
We'll need a hacksaw to cut it loose.
What?
A hacksaw! Just go to a hardware store and ask for a damn hacksaw, then get the hell over here. I need help.
Okay, I'll be there as soon as I can.
So what happened?
Well, it didn't turn out exactly the way we planned. Don't worry, you can still go over and make the arrest. Only you'll be arresting Frank instead of my late husband.
It'd be a shame if old Frank tries to resist arrest. I'd have no choice but to shoot him.
God, I just love the way you look in that uniform.
Escape artist in the world!
They make a-